Welcome back. So are you ready for a few more examples of non-linear thinking? Good. How about this situation? Someone very near and dear to you has hurt you deeply and is clearly wrong. Maybe it's a friend or even a family member. You're so upset you've stopped talking to this person, and to make matters worse, he or she refuses to apologize or even admit doing anything wrong. You feel that resuming the relationship would be condoning this person's behavior, so you break off all communications to protect yourself from further pain. Has this ever happened to you? It's happened to a lot of us, and the linear response is to emotionally disengage from what your brain perceives to be the source of the pain. You don't really want to lose the relationship, but you don't see any alternative solution. This is a classic linear response from the reptilian part of your brain that's programmed to always move toward pleasure and away from pain. And it works. Sort of. Yes, if you remove yourself from the person's life, they can no longer hurt you. Congratulations, you win. But it's a booby prize at best because you've given up an important relationship in the process. To win the real prize, non-linear thinking is required. So let's move to a higher level of consciousness and start with a simple idea. Everyone in the world is operating at his or her current level of awareness, and that includes the person that hurt you. 95% of the population is operating out of a fear and scarcity based mindset, and we all know that people who are frightened make lousy decisions. Chances are the person that hurt you did so out of fear and has not yet developed the knowledge or skill to transcend this level of thinking. Odds are that his or her hurtful act had nothing to do with you. It was simply a scared human being taking a shortcut out of fear. Let me give an example of how you're already using a nonlinear solution to a problem most of us have encountered. You're on an airplane, and there's a 2-year-old in the next row screaming and crying. You don't go over there to the kid and say, "Hey, this is an exit row seat, man. You can't be crying. It's not right. What are you thinking? What kind of show are you running, little man?" You don't do that. Why not? Because it's a 2-year-old, and that's what 2-year-olds do. They scream and they cry. Why? Because they're bad? No, because they're operating at a lower level of awareness. You don't blame the little guy because he's only doing what he's mentally capable of at this point in his life. Adults are no different. All of us are operating at different levels of conscious awareness. That's why some people are C students in college and others are Rhodes Scholars. Sure, hard work and effort play a role. But generally speaking, people who excel in school, sports, or anything else are operating at a higher level of awareness in this particular area. Back in my days as a struggling tennis player, I remember doing a service return drill with the great Andre Agassi. Another great player of that time period named Tim Mayotte was serving balls at us, and we were taking turns hitting service returns. Mayotte had one of the fastest serves in the world at that time, and Andre Agassi was pummeling the ball back almost as hard as Mayotte was serving it. I was barely getting my racket on it, and finally I asked Agassi how he developed such a great return of serve. Andre is a really nice guy, and he said, "Steve, it's all in your head. It's all in your head. You just got to concentrate on the ball more." As much as I wanted to believe he was right, I knew he was wrong. I was 6 years older than him. That means I had 6 more years of practicing service returns and working on my concentration. It wasn't in my head. I was simply operating at my level of awareness in the game of tennis, and he was operating at his. My level of awareness was upper class, and his was world class. I could have practiced another 25 years and still not reached his level of awareness in the game of tennis. So here's the point of my story. The person that hurt you is doing the best he or she can at their current level of awareness, and so are you and I. Instead of waiting for them to elevate their thinking, take a nonlinear approach and forgive their behavior. Transcend your ego and just let it go. I need to take a short break, but when we come back, I'll tell you the story of how I set a world record in dating. I'll also share with you more nonlinear solutions. Don't go away.